Hi, I'm Matthew Coast, head dating coach at CommitmentConnection.com, and in today's video, we're going to talk about how to get a guy to value you more. So if you feel like you're being taken for granted and you want a guy to feel like you're an incredibly valuable woman to him, I'm going to give you five different ways to make sure that he feels like you're that amazing, valuable, special woman in his life. So if this is your first time to our channel, make sure that you go down and hit the subscribe button to get more videos on how to attract and keep the man that you want to have in your life. So let's get started. So when a guy values you, what ends up happening is that he starts to feel like you're unique. He starts to feel like you're special. And the higher that your value raises in his eyes, the more that he'll feel like you're a woman that he wants to commit to, a woman that he wants to give his everything to, a woman that he wants to invest in, a woman that he wants to take off the market, a woman that he doesn't want to lose, right? And so you want to raise your value as high as you can in his eyes without making him feel like you're unattainable. And so here are the different ways that you're going to do it. So number one is to make him work for your attention and satisfaction. So the more that a guy invests in you, the more that a guy works for you, the more that he'll value you. And so if he invests in you from the aspects of time, energy, emotion, physical investment, touching you, doing things like financial investment, the more ways that he invests in you, the more he'll feel like he doesn't want to let you go. And so a lot of women, what they do is there's a guy that they really like, and they do all the things that he should be doing, right? They're investing in him. They're spending money on him. They're doing all these things for him. They become the social planner of his life. They, you know, do all these things where they're investing in this guy and they feel like this guy is really great. And then the guy's like, I don't have any investment in this at all. I don't think it's a big deal if I leave. Whereas if he's the one that does all the investments, he's going to feel like, oh, she's this awesome woman, I don't want her to go. And the way that you do that is by leaning back. You gotta lean back. A lot of women freak out because they think if they start leaning back, a guy is going to kind of disappear. And in reality, a guy's more likely to disappear if you don't lean back, right? He's gonna start feeling smothered. He's gonna start feeling like he needs to pull away and he needs some time to himself. And instead, you want him to be coming to you. You want him to be investing in you. You want him to be planning things. You want him to be putting the effort in. And the only way that you can do that is by creating a space and then inviting him to do those things for you instead of being all on top of him and making him do and doing those things for him. So number two is making him aware that you're choosing him, but you're not completely tied down to him yet. And we actually got a question in on our channel not too long ago from a woman who said that she wanted to let a guy know that she was going to date other people because she felt like he wasn't going anywhere, but he was like angry about it and she didn't know what to do. And my response was, you should tell him that you really like him, right? You need to tell him that you like him and that you think he's a great guy and that you think he's amazing, but you don't want to get serious with anybody who's not serious with you. Because if you get serious with him and he's not serious with you, there's an analogy that I use where it's like you tell him that there's this awesome pool that you're jumping into and you jump into the pool and you're there swimming by yourself. And he's up there like, well, I wasn't even really sure that I wanted to get into the pool yet. And if you jump in the pool before he does, then you might be swimming by yourself. And that's why you need to know that he's going to be serious before you get serious with him. And so my suggestion, one, is that you date other people and you let him know that you like him and you think he's awesome, but you're looking for something serious. And if he's not willing to get serious with you, then you're going to start seeing other people. So number three is not allowing bad behavior, right? Not allowing insulting behavior. So a lot of times, women, guys, so what guys do is they'll test boundaries, right? They'll see how far you're willing to let them go. And a lot of times women let a guy walk all over them because they're afraid that they're going to lose the guy. But that shows a guy that you don't think very highly of yourself. You don't respect yourself, and then he's not going to respect you. So instead, what you want to do is you want to have boundaries, and you want to set those boundaries. And if he tries to push past those boundaries, you want to either back away or tell him that that's not okay and that you're not okay with whatever behavior that he's doing. And so, you know, the more that you kind of push back against him kind of testing your boundaries, the more he'll feel like you're valuable. And it's a really easy and simple way to kind of show a man that you have value is by creating and maintaining boundaries. So number four is when a guy kind of like pulls away a bit, what you want to do is make him work harder when he comes back to you to win you over. And so a lot of times what ends up happening in relationships is people need time, right? They need time away. They need to pull back. They have other things that they might have an emergency that's going on. Maybe he feels smothered and so he needs some time to himself. Whatever it is, a lot of times guys will pull back or and pull away. And when he comes back, you want to kind of lean back and give him some space and allow him to work harder to kind of win you over and get back to the same space that you were in the relationship so that you create, this goes along with number one, so that you create that, he creates that investment in you and feels like you're this amazing woman that he doesn't want to let go of. So number five, this is one of the most important ones that a lot of women kind of skip over. And sometimes women don't have the balance for it, right? And it's what it is kind of this lifestyle element of kind of having things going on in your own life, like achieving something great for yourself, having something amazing going on, having it so that it's not just you and him, right? A lot of times what women will do is they'll get into a relationship with a guy, and then it's like every moment of his life that is free, she tries to fill it up with stuff to do with her. Right. And so she's like, oh, it's Saturday. You know, we're waking up. We're going for brunch. We're going to go for a hike. We're going to go to this concert. We're going to do all these things. Right. And then the guy's like, hey, I need some time to like just chill out and have to myself. And if you create that time for him before he asks you for it, because you've already got things going on that are interesting in your own life, he'll value you a lot more. He'll feel like you're an amazing woman because you'll stand out from all the other women that he met. And instead of smothering him and kind of pushing him away and making him feel like he needs more time, he'll feel like he wants to be closer to you. He'll feel like he wants to be more with you. And I want to talk about this on the extreme as well, because a lot of women make the mistake of kind of pulling back so far, having so much going on in their lives that they don't have any room for a guy to be there. And that's not what I'm talking about here. What I'm talking about is a balance in the middle. One, not smothering him and being all over him. And two, not having so many things going on that you don't have time for him at all. And so there's this middle ground where you have things that you do and it's fun and it's awesome, but you also have time to hang out with him and spend time with him and build a deeper relationship with him. Thanks for watching this video. If you're ready to know exactly what to say and do to attract the man and the relationship you've always wanted, click on the button on the right-hand side of this video and go to our website.